That's why I call my thing the marathon, because I'm not gonna lie and portray this ultimate poise like I've been had it figured out. Nah, I just didn't quit. That's the only distinguishing quality from me and probably whoever else going through this or went through this or is gonna go through this, is that I ain't quit. I went through every emotion. I went through every emotion with trying to pursue what I'm doing. You know what I mean? And I think that what gonna separate whoever's gonna try to go for something is that you ain't gonna quit. Unless, you know, you're gonna really take the stance if I'm gonna die behind what I'm getting at right.
If you ever needed motivation to get out and hustle, look no further than the late great Nipsey Hussle. He led by example always and left behind plenty words of wisdom that teach us how to hustle the right way, the Nipsey Hussle way. This is Hustle and Motivate, so stick around for the breakdown. Our culture is full of wealth, talent, passion, style, history, and influence. This culture was built by remarkable people who impact the world every single day, but nobody talks about how they do it. What are the skills they possess to entertain, inspire, and shake up the world? Now, we're gonna talk about it. I'ma pay homage to those leading the way. I'm Jamal Nolan, and this is Culture Breakdown. If you don't know who Nipsey Hussle is, or didn't know much about him before his untimely death, let me explain. Nipsey was a West Coast rapper who had been in the game for years. His debut album, Victory Lap, was Grammy nominated. He was an incredible hustler and businessman, known for uplifting and empowering his neighborhood, Crenshaw. It's so much more that can be said about his life, but let me get right into the principle. Principle number three, all money in.
I was just saying, like, you know, I showed up, obviously, and done my part, but I always do, not to sound crazy. So the difference is the team activated this time.
Right. We created the agency, which is a partnership between George Finiche, Karen Civil, and Stephen Carless and myself. And when I say myself, I mean all money in.
Yeah, but it's a team effort, though, you know what I mean?
I was going to do the deal. Mm-hmm. Is what when Ross put the MMG thing on the table, just the terms and the way, you know, Ross set up the conversation to start in that building, it was a great opportunity. It was a great situation. I just had a concern with my team getting credit for breaking Nipsey Hussle. So I didn't necessarily want to take that from my team. Mm-hmm. So I got a lot of respect for Rose. So I'd have done it off just GP, but I got a team I committed to ahead of time.
Damn.
And I needed to make sure they got the credit for what they did. You know what I mean?
You can watch any Nipsey interview and you'll notice just how much credit he gives his team. He realizes that he's the one in front of the camera getting all the credit, but he wants to make it very clear that he didn't do it alone. This is the first principle that's twofold or two-in-one that I've done on this channel. Part one, have a strong team of people who's smarter than you and people whose opinion you trust. Part two, always give your team the credit they deserve. It'll boost them and validate their effort. So, if you're an entrepreneur, start looking to build a team. You can only go so far alone. And really, this principle is threefold because all money in is an investment principle in and of itself. Man, what a genius. Principle number two, integrate it vertically.
I'm integrated vertically, y'all niggas blew it.
I said, my cultural influence even rival Lucian. I'm integrated vertically, y'all niggas blew it. They tell me hustle, dumb it down, you might confuse them. This ain't that weirdo rap, you motherfuckers. Your few companies or brands are integrated vertically. Ford was integrated vertically from production to consumption. They owned every part of the supply chain. Mm-hmm. And I look at myself as one of the artists. I would say Jay-Z might be the only one. He owns Title, and he owns his masters. And that's the space we exist in.
You 360 yourself and you exercise control.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
What do you mean by that?
Yeah, like, you know, 360 myself. Put businesses in other categories that was driven by the music, like the clothing and like the agency and, you know, feedback, positive feedback for marketing decisions. Well, we should be able to leverage that to offer marketing services as a company. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so, just building businesses around the music thing, just like traditionally a label would monetize around you.
I always felt like what makes Apple dope is that it's a complete ecosystem. You get your phone, the same colors that the operating system on your phone is, the same colors of their store, it's the same colors of the packaging of the product. A vertically integrated is the word. Like, I didn't see that in rap, you know what I mean? I think Jay-Z, one of the artists that's in that direction, he owned Title. That's the retail space for his product.
Shout out to the boss.
For sure, shout out to Jigga. he owned his master. So from actual conception to consumption, he can curate the whole experience.
This is such an important lesson. I think a lot of times as entrepreneurs, we think about what we can sell rather than what we can own. Even when we think ownership, it's not vertically integrated. We own bits and pieces, but not the entire process. He is right about Jay-Z and Apple. They've created an experience that you can get all your needs here. You don't have to go anywhere else, which ultimately means more money and more trust invested in your brand. Be a supplier for all your consumers' needs. Principle number one, the marathon.
I mean, like, the marathon is an idea that it first was expressed on music, and then obviously through clothes with the marathon clothing. But then it's an idea that, you know, if you really think about the metaphor of the marathon, when you look at it as like life, it's about endurance, it's about preparing, it's about mentally breaking through your barriers that tell you I can't keep going, where you know you're more capable of what of you don't you more capable than you think you are and then you're conscious of. So the name of the brand obviously is the marathon, and it just stands for endurance, it stands for staying down, it stands for like not quitting, accepting the ups and downs of whatever game you commit yourself to and riding it out, you feel me? Because, you know, that's the reality of, you know, success or greatness, that it come with a roller coaster ride, you know? So I think that anybody could apply the marathon concept to what they do, if it's sports, if it's fashion, if it's music, if it's hustling, whatever, you're just on a you're on a marathon, you know? So to make that the basis of our, you know, fashion line, I look at it like, you know, we honor the people that ain't quit. We honor the people that stayed down.
I honestly couldn't elaborate, break down, or explain that principle any better than Nipsey just did. This man served as a huge inspiration to me and millions of others. And it's unfortunate that he was taken away from us so soon. But his life, his words, his actions serve as inspiration that can empower generations to come. On Victory Lap, he said,
Tupac of my generation.
And that's true in so many different ways. As great as Tupac's life was, he was more impactful and inspirational after his death. And the same is true for Nipsey. Thank you guys for watching this week's episode of Culture Breakdown. And until next week, I'm out.
Thank you guys for watching all the way to the end of the video. If you're still here watching, be sure to hit the subscribe button over here. YouTube thinks you're gonna like this video over here. I say you should watch this one as well. Thank you for sticking around. Be sure to subscribe. Until next week, I'm out.